Hey guys, Drifter here. Today I've got a short video for you about the Black Ops 4 Blackout Beta. That's a lot of B words all at the same time. Gonna try to do this one quickly because unfortunately I got food poisoning. I'm leaking from both ends and may not be able to sit here for too long. So briefly, the beta is gonna start on September 10th for PlayStation 4. For Xbox, it's gonna be September 14th. Which is only 4 days later instead of a week. A little strange on that one. PC is also going to be September 14th if you pre-ordered, and on September 15th, there's going to be an open beta for PC, which personally I expect to be huge. Any sort of open beta for a BR game should be really, really big, especially for Call of Duty, so I hope a lot of people try it out. The way to get into the Blackout beta is really simple. You just keep your Black Ops 4 beta installed on your system, if that was PC, PS4, Xbox, whatever. You just keep that old multiplayer beta installed, and on September 10th or 14th or 15th, it will just automatically turn into the Blackout data with an update patch, of course. So you just sit there and do nothing, and when the date comes around, your system will update and you're good to go. But the juicier, more interesting part of this video is a leak that comes from a community member. The guy's name is Brad, or Lime Tiger X. He appears to be a PC modder for Black Ops 3, a hobbyist map designer, and just a guy that likes to poke around on PC. Well, he was poking around with the PC Black Ops 4 beta files to see what he could find, and he found some tiny strings for description and little bits of code that seemed to indicate some interesting facts. Fact number one is he found a string that says play against up to 100 players, so I assume the Blackout player count is 100. I don't know why it says up to, I guess that's just a marketing term. Hopefully it's 100 on all systems, but for me that's great news. That means no tiny battle royale for COD, no compromising battle royale for COD. We can fill out the whole map, which is supposed to be huge, and it should be really fun. The bad news is I have no idea how the engine is going to handle this, since regular multiplayer seems to struggle with frame rates and resolutions right now. Hopefully Treyarch does some optimizations and kind of patches that up before launch. Hopefully they're already optimizing things from the beta, or perhaps Blackout just has less, you know, particles, less effects, less explosions, and less graphical detail, which burdens the engine less, and I think that would be the smarter choice for them. The other neat thing is that he found strings of code that seem to indicate that you can freefall to parachute, parachute begin and end strings. There's one funny one that says free fall to land, we'll talk about in a little bit, and one that says parachute landing. There was a leak almost 2 months ago that said Treyarch was kind of 50-50 on whether they were going to use parachutes or not. They kind of wanted people to parachute in the map, but it wasn't working well, and they thought as like an easier workaround, they could do the Call of Duty Online weird like tube through the ground deployment system. But I hope that these strings are indicative that parachutes are going to be used in the Blackout beta. However, it may be leftover code. That just could be some legacy code being in there, and there are no parachutes, but I certainly hope there are, because I think that parachuting in a battle royale game is more fun, it feels more epic, and it allows you to make better tactical decisions. You get to literally choose where you're landing, you get to see where other people are landing and redirect, and it's really fun like that. I did note that there are some interesting ones that says free fall to land and parachute to land, and I think it would be hilarious if the parachutes didn't automatically deploy and you could just free fall and just face plant right on the ground and die. That would be great, and it would just immediately kill off AFKs. You couldn't AFK in this game out of the plane. You would just die, which would be wonderful. It would also be kind of funny if they decided to copy Battlefield and allow you to redeploy off of tall buildings, and that's kind of what I think is going to happen, because even in the trailer you saw a guy jumping off of a building in sort of a squirrel like wingsuit thing. So I imagine the extra mobility for this is that you get to jump off of tall buildings and wingsuit around, which would be your parachute deploy from a building. But if you don't pull the chute at the right time, you just face plant into the ground, which would be good. Overall, this is looking like good news for Call of Duty Blackout. It's the mode that I've wanted to play more than multiplayer. I'm ready for it. My body is ready, especially the PC open beta. And hopefully I see you there. Drifter out.